Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create overlapping vertical photo strips from a single photo and then colorize and effect each strip individually, creating a fun, interesting look. Open a photo you'd like to use. I downloaded this portrait from Shutterstock.com. Make a copy of your photo by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Click the adjustment layer icon and choose solid color. Pick white and click OK. We want to bring the color fill adjustment layer below layer 1. There are two ways of doing this. One way is to drag it to the line between layer 1 and the background and then release. I'll press Ctrl or Command Z to undo the last step. The second way to place the color fill below layer 1 is to use the shortcut Ctrl or Command plus the left bracket key. Click the thumbnail of layer 1 to make it active and open your rectangle tool. Choose Shape. If you're working on a version earlier than CS6, the shape icon is here. The fill color is irrelevant since we're ultimately going to fill the shape with the photo. Make sure the stroke is empty. Its symbol is the red diagonal line. Drag a vertical rectangular shape across your image. Position the rectangle below layer 1. To move or rotate it, open your transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. When you see a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. You can always change it later. I'll drag the shape over the left side of the portrait. Drag any middle point on the edges to extend or shorten the shape. To accept the transform, press Enter or Return. Make the top layer active. Make it into a clipping mask by pressing Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. This clips the photo to the shape directly below it, hiding everything on the photo except for the area inside the shape. Make the rectangle layer active and click the FX icon. Choose Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply and the opacity is 20%. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 132 degrees. For this photo, I'll make the distance 20 pixels and the size 5 pixels. However, keep in mind, you may want to use different amounts for the distance and size depending on the size and resolution of your photo. Click Stroke. Click the color box. Pick White and click OK. Make the position inside. Click Color Overlay and change the blend mode to Hue. Click the color box and pick a color you like to colorize your photo. You can always change it later. Click off the eyeball next to Color Overlay to temporarily hide the effect. Next, we'll group the clipped photo and the shape into a folder. To do this, Shift-click on the photo to highlight it, and then press Ctrl or Command-G. Make a copy of the folder and position the copy under the original. Open the folder copy and click the rectangle thumbnail to make the shape active. Open the Path Selection tool and drag the copy to the right. Open your Transform tool to angle and position it to your liking. Then press Enter or Return. Remember, you can always go back and change it later. Close the folder, make a copy, and position Copy 2 below Copy 1. Open the folder of Copy 2, and as before, make the rectangle shape active. Open your Transform tool to reposition and angle it. Continue the same steps to create the rest of the vertical panels. Now that we have our finished vertical strip portrait, let's change the hues of each individual panel. Open the top folder and click next to Color Overlay to make it visible. Close the folder and open the folder directly below it. Make its Color Overlay visible and double-click on the words Color Overlay to see it in the Layer Style window. Click on the color box and pick another color and click OK on both windows. Continue these steps for the rest of the panels. If you have CS6 or later, I'll show you how you can use the color lookup filters to give each panel its own unique look. First, make sure the color overlay effect is hidden on all of your panels. Make the clipped photo active and click the adjustment layer icon. Choose color lookup and click the clip to layer icon. This will restrict the effect to the individual panel below it in the Layers panel. Open Load 3D LUT. Each of these effects were historically used by the film industry to apply specific looks to film scenes. Go through each one to determine which one you like for your individual panels. Once you've chosen the one you want, click on it to apply the effect. Close the folder and open the one above it. As before, make the clipped photo active, click the adjustment layer, and choose color lookup. Clip it, and pick another effect. Continue adding different effects to each panel until you're happy with the result. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.